When I make desktop 2.0 and 2.1 recommendations, it's usually Micca's or Pioneer's or Dayton's, and it's usually Li-Pi amps or toppings. But at the end of that, I say, well, why don't you grab yourself an AMP-100? And this is the AudioSource AMP-100. It is 50 watts per channel as opposed to the usual 20 watts per channel you get on Indeed or Li-Pi's or the toppings. And it is not a T-amp. It is not these little things here. They're super light. They're convenient. But they distort when you really try to push them. And this will not distort when you really push it. Because this is a real amplifier. This is class AB. This has a big toroidal transformer. This has a heat sink. It generates heat. It also has features. And it's not a lot of features. It's got AB speakers. It's actually got a balance knob, which I like because it's about 80% either way is no change at all. It'll auto turn off, which it kind of has to because it's way more power consumption than a T-amp. The back here we've got an unswitched power plug, which is great for what I'm about to show you it can do. Your AB terminals, 5-way binding posts, has the ability to bridge mono. So instead of being 50 watts in stereo or 60 watts for 4 ohm, you could bridge it and get 105 or 110 watts at 8 ohm for one channel. If you want to use two of these, that's fine. You could switch here for if you wanted to auto turn off or just stay on all the time. And it has line input 1, line input 2, and line 2 out, which is interesting. I haven't seen that before. That says line 2 out. Now, I'm going to run the gamut with this amplifier right now. I'm going to hook everything to it. I'm going to show you the ultimate desk setup. And I'm going to do so with the cover back on it. For safety's sake. Here we go. I don't want to drop anything expensive in there. Well, with me today is my kilowatt. So we're going to be able to see the power consumption of this beast. I'll say this, I plugged my Li-Pi. This little Li-Pi, it's actually not mine, it's getting given away to my little cousin. And I plugged that in, and that averaged about 2 watts playing, 5 watts when it was loud, and 15 watts peak. So let's see what this comes out to. 29, 6, 4. Nothing happening. No volume. So that's not super bad. All right, we're going to plug this in. I've got the Behringer DAC here, and one of the caveats of this and the weirdness of it is you have to plug your main thing that you want to play into line 2. This is left. This is right. So line 2 in. If you don't plug it into line 2 in, it's on the auto switch feature, which will be demonstrated using this auxiliary cable. This is going to go into line 1. And the little cow-on player I have here, which will eventually turn on. And do yourself a huge favor and buy banana plugs, because trying to wire A isn't bad, because you have access right on top to unscrewing the terminals. But B, if you try to go on top, is a nightmare. If you go on the bottom, it's going to stick out a little bit. Well, I made my life much simpler by putting these cheapo bananas on. I'll link these if I can find them again. They were month ago I found them. So let's see, B is bottom, and these are there. Look how simple this makes it. Oh god, what a nightmare I had the other day hooking this up without these. Okay, so now I have two sets of speakers. I have Micca MB42s with the crossovers added, so now they're X's, and I've got the original BS21 Pioneers, which after reading all of Strategic Deceiver's reviews, yes, they're missing the highs, but they have a warmth to them. It's starting to grow on me, and I think, I don't know. We'll, those are for another time. Those are another time thing. And now, the other set of RCAs that are here, I'm going to plug my wires into as well, because these don't have a headphone out, this amp. Neither of those amps has a headphone out. Some of the toppings have a headphone out. And since this has a line out, which will pass through what's coming into it, amplifying to speakers, and then it'll just pass through to this, you can grab yourself God, don't drop it. A headphone amp, like this shit Magni, plug it into the auxiliary, and then if you remember what colors you're looking at, this is white, and this is red. Bam. Now you've got the ultimate desk setup, if only this wasn't as stiff a wire as it currently is. Bam. So, 50 watts per channel speaker, A and B, line out to a Rape headphone amp, which is powered by the unit, and I think when you shut it off, no, it's unswitched, so you're still going to have to shut it off manually. And we've got an auxiliary in right here for MP3 or FLAC player in this case. And we've got two sets of speakers, and we've got the kilowatt that's going to tell us how much wattage we're using. And if I find my mouse and make sure that volume's all the way down, we could start this. Power on. Speaker A, which is the MV42s, it goes click. Switch to the B. I don't know if you're gonna be able to tell until I dub over this recorder. And this has rubber feet that I don't have on it. So it's just sliding all over the place with these massive aftermarket wires. No! I'll pull it off of YouTube, you bastards. Gonna switch the mics out. Why am I? I'm on one bar, so I better hurry this up. Alright, next song. Something catchy. Why is it only on AudioSource? Pretty sure that'll get me yanked. There we go. Nightmare Before Christmas seems to work. Now this is the lower speakers, and I probably, if you're not going to do an A and B speaker set on your desk, really, what you can do is the lower B connectors, if you get yourself a powered sub, like a 10-inch Dayton or a 12-inch Dayton, you could run the speaker wires out and into the amp ins of a powered sub, and then you could just literally shut it off. You get them both, you can power both at the same time, or just one at a time. And I don't know what I want to test next. Put this on one bar.
Teeth ground sharp and eyes glowing red.
I am the one hiding under your stairs. Fingers like snakes and spiders in my hair.
This is Halloween.
Just
this
a mic.
Is
nothing
Halloween.
Else.
Halloween, 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 Halloween.
Now we're on the pioneers.
In the star, we call home. Everyone hail to the pumpkin song.
In this town,
we love it now. Everybody's waiting for the next surprise.
Round that corner man hiding in the trash can. Something's waiting out of pants. And how you say?
This is Halloween.
Red and black.
It's bloody green.
Aren't you scared?
Well, that's just fine. Say it once, say it twice. Take a chance and roll the dice. Riding with the
moon. Whoa, ho, 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 ho. Okay. What you'll basically notice about the difference between the Micas and the Pioneers is I've done tests with the sound pressure level meter, and they actually are the same volume. It's just the Micas use their tweeters so much more. And it's kind of harsh at high volume. I think the Pioneers are a little bit sweeter to listen to at full volume.
Filling your dreams to the brim with fright.
This is Halloween, this is Halloween.
I switch to the Micas.
Halloween, 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 Halloween.
But now, we're not here to review speakers, we're here to review the amp, which is obviously capable of powering them pretty high. I mean, I had that up to full for the Pioneers, because they're so, what's the word I'm looking for? Well, they don't quite have the highs to bother you. Dull? I'll say dull. They're so dull, you can put them up to, the absolute maximum. This is why they're really good for home theater. Because you could punch the crap out of them. Now, back to features. Okay, A and B or A and B. You can have both on, but they recommend only 8-ohm speakers for that. That's fine. Let's line out now. Actually. I may have encountered a problem that I wasn't prepared for. Because I got my headphones right here. Top of the Sunny D. best headphones you could buy right now. Grab a set of these NVXs, and I'm going to plug them in, full quarter inch. And of course the song ends. And it's playing. All right. No problem. All you have to do, I don't want to have the speakers playing. You can't shut off A and B. They have to, one has to be on. So if you don't have B hooked up, you could switch to it. It's outputting to nothingness. But if you do have speakers on it, you would simply lower the volume down all the way. And now just your headphones are playing whatever you want. And you don't have to use a shit Magni. I have here my Secret Santa gift from Reddit, which is pretty cool. It's the little Fio EO 6, and all you'd need is one of these, or an RCA to 3.5mm wire. You plug this in, it's USB powered, you can plug that into your computer, and then you just plug your headphone into that, and it would take the place. You would have this amp lining out into this, so you'd have headphone capability for, like, this thing's like $29. This little Fio E6. And it's pretty damn, it's pretty good. It's as loud, it gets my headphones as loud as my Cowon does. Which is impressive, because that's a very good amped unit. So, if you ever need, if you ever buy the setup, the 2.1 setup, and say, oh, I want to add a headphone out. If you don't have the Behringer DAC, you don't want to use the headphone out on this, because it is rather crappy. The lineouts in this are great. The headphone out is not great. So you would end up getting something like this, or spending the $100 and getting something like this. This way you can blast your cans and your speakers all simultaneous. Wall of sound. Look at the wires back there. This is the stuff that gets me hot. Cable porn, here we come. Well, they respect a little bit cleaner setup, but I hung it off the edge. One thing I should mention about both of these things is the edges are so sharp. I mean, this is so sharp. I mean, should I bleed for you? I could bleed for you if I just dragged my hand across it. And sharp is good. Sharp means it's a manly thing. It doesn't have these round edges like these new kids need fans that don't cut your hands off. How good is that? So, yeah. Headphone amp can be looped straight out. I believe only on line 2. We're going to find out in a second. As I hook up my player here, you're going to see the features. Features are about to go down. It's already switched over. Playing. How's my output level? Put to 45. Alright. It's automatically switched from the Die Hard soundtrack to Never Neverland by Uncle. Now, if I pause this, wait a second. Switches back to line 1. So, that's why you can't use these backwards. You have to use line 2 as your main, or else it's just going to click on and off all day looking for signal on line 2. Alright, so, you got your music playing. What's going on? Oh, but wait, I want to hear my band. It's already on. Let me see what's coming out of this. Hold on. Ah. A failure. All right. This output will only pass through line 2. What's coming through the auxiliary into line 1 will not go out and be passed through a headphone amplifier. That's sort of gay. A little bit gay. But, you know, what can I tell you? If you want to add a real preamp to the top of this, I'll link to this kooky little one I found on some crappy website. It's the only one like it I've ever found on the internet. $77. And it's just, you know, 3 inputs and a phono input. So you hook up an old turntable and then a line out. It's got a volume control and buttons in the front. And they don't sell it anywhere else. Nowhere else can you find a preamp that's just like, I want a volume control and 3 inputs. You find me one that has a volume control and 3 inputs with a remote, and I'll gift you something. I don't know what I'll gift you, but I cannot find a preamp to record. What a preamp is just a source switcher with a volume knob. So you're supposed to get a big ass amp like this, put it all the way up, and then you get just a box you plug all your crap into, and you have a volume knob. And he said, I want to hear the CD player, or I want to hear my Dreamcast, and here's the volume. And the amp just sits there getting signal and raises it up and plays your speakers. And this has sort of a preamp in it, because it's a little switch. There's a switch inputs, but that's not really a preamp. I mean, it's automatic, number one, so you can't control it. What's playing now? That's Beethoven. So, pause this. A few seconds later, Beethoven will click over. And this is always playing Beethoven. This is only playing what the computer's outputting through line two. That's playing it through this shit magni, which is being powered. Now, if I shut it off, let's see something. Ah! Still playing Beethoven. So that means you could have this unit completely. I wonder if you can unplug it. Nope, you cannot unplug it. How much wattage is that using? Damn, mofo. All right, this amp is using 5 watts when the power switch is out. And that's got to be to pass through that, which is a little odd. Don't know why it would need that. Should just pass through. Look at this mess. Look at this mess of cool audio stuff I've got going on here. Yeah. Cool audio stuff. Yeah. I haven't tested it in bridge mode where you hook up just one speaker to it. I don't have any speakers big enough. Even those are not really need 100 watts, and then it'll only be one channel. It'll be weird, and I have to disassemble everything. I'm assuming it'll work fine with bridge switch. And that came on pretty quick from that. So yeah, there you go. One of the more versatile, cheap. I paid $104. I remember a couple months ago, this was like $90. And I should have picked one up, because it went up like $140 forever. 6 months, it was $140. And only when it dropped around Christmas did I say, I need to have one. And I'm going to put this on my television. And it's going to power a set of Micca X's to their absolute extreme. Pioneers are very soft. Oh, there was a little bit of dirt in the volume knob, I'll have to admit to that. Here's the balance, which is backwards because I'm recording this backwards. There you go. It's very quiet, so it's got something. Alright. Balance knob. From like there, and now it's here, and this whole rest of this travel brings sound that long. Oh god, the balance knob is very well designed because it goes full left, and then as soon as you turn, it's like, okay, now here, and it slowly travels across the front of you, and then it jumps to the other side. So you can actually, if you can't move the speakers, and you're sitting down, you put it in mono, and you're like, I want to hear where that voice is coming from. If the voice isn't dead center in a mono track, it's there. You can adjust that if moving the speakers doesn't do it. Because really, if you're sitting down in the center and you have a mono track playing, and you switch it to mono, switch to a mono output on a stereo track, if someone's singing or drums or anything, it should be dead center, measurable dead center. And if it isn't, if it's there, that means that this speaker is too prominent. You push the speaker back like a quarter inch, 3/8 of an inch, and it'll, you bring that forward, and it'll bring it over. Bring this forward, and it brings it over. We push this one back, and it brings it over. And after that, if you can't accomplish with that, then you do a balance. You really never need a balance knob, ever. It's all has to do with distance to the speaker. Minute changes will fix your, soundstage or imaging. Imaging is more what it is defined as. Then you take it out of mono, and everything sounds beautiful. So yeah, I'm proud of this purchase. It does a lot of things. And it does get a little warm right over this. So if you're going to put this on your desk, make sure you, if you're going to put this on your desk under your monitor, which is probably where I would put it if I had a desk to put this on, didn't have a 97-pound CRT, make sure you don't cover this a lot. I'll allow like that much covering. Or maybe you've got like a thin one that just covers a strip of this. But do not cover 60% of this or it will just die. It needs air to live. That's my headphones playing. Oh, Christ, I have up all the way. I thought that was the speakers. Okay. They're only $80. I'll buy another pair. It's fine. It's fine. I don't need those. Nope, balance is over there. What are the balance effects? Hold on. It shouldn't. No, balance does not affect line out. Oh, it gets so loud with this Magni. That's dumb. Yeah, okay, so here's the ultimate desk setup, as far as I'm concerned, because you can do everything you need to do. Oh, it's on headphones. Oh, the low-end rumble on that.
Yeah.
Oh, God. I murdered the camera. Okay. 21 minutes. That's why I use this. I think I've proven this amp has many, many a capability. You're not going to find these wires either. I bought those on a wholesale website. They were being sold out for like $1.20 a piece. I bought like 12 of them. I bought exactly 12. So you can shut that off. Shut that off. It drops to zero. Hold on a second. Ah, look at that. How the hell does that work? So, if you've got something attached to the pass-through, and it's on, it's 5 watts draw. But if you shut it off... Oh, because I'm powering it through it. I'm stupid. I'm dumb. This is... I'm stupid. I'm stupid. This is stupid as hell. Yeah. This is being powered through there. So that's why it's reading 5 watts. That's as high as it'll read? Yeah. It's a 16 volt on this, by the way. So 5 watts maximum draw. I'm pretty sure you could run this with a battery. And that's the AudioSource AMP 100. It's a damn good amp. By the way, 10.8 pounds. Another one that's way heavier than it looks. Thanks to all that goodies inside. Now to take it all apart and plug it up to my television.